First one is scopes and resources. Scope is a mechanism in OAuth 2 to limit the application access to users' protected API resource. An application can request one or more scopes. This information is presented to the user in the consent screen. And the access token issued to the application will be limited to the scopes granted. The OAuth spec allows the authorization server or user to modify the scope granted to the application compared to what is requested. Scope is typically about what access being requested, but it is sometimes overloaded to convey the location or identity of the protected resource. However, doing so isn't always feasible or desirable. Resource indicators spec RFC 8707 is introduced. I was talking about the RFC 8707, which is introduced for the client to explicitly signal to the authorization server where it intends to redeem the access token it is requesting. We can include multiple resource parameters in the authorization request to notify authorization server about it. Then the token types and validations. So let's first decide what type of token is required for your API. Here we can have two types of token. Reference token, where you always need to go to the authorization server for validation, and JWT, which is self-contained and can be validated without the help of authorization server. If you need a multi-region deployment or high concurrency, JWT token makes sense. But it has some disadvantages also. The main one is we can't revoke it like we do for the reference token. So for critical operation, it will be a good idea to introspect the JWT. Then we need to decide on the validity period. There are several factors govern this decision. First one is user. User can be system admin, app developer, or an app consumer. Based on user privileges, we can decide the validity period. Even refresh token is allowed or not allowed for them. Higher the privileges, less validity period is allowed. So also we need to decide based on the operation asset. If it is a transaction, having one-time token for the specific transaction will be a good idea. Rich authorization request or RA is a draft which we can use to specify fine-grained authorization requirement in the authorization request. As an example, if that specification is used, we can mention the transaction ID in the authorization request and get access token specific to that transaction. Based on the go-to factor, we can decide whether to provide refresh token or not as well. Okay, the security enforcement part. Most common one is API gateway pattern. In this way, all the traffic will go through an API gateway like WS2 API manager, and the scopes and other validations like validity period, all those things will be enforced there.